गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. एज यू नो दैट आवर यूनिट रिप्रोडक्शन इज गोइंग ऑन, सो दिस इज द लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ आवर यूनिट रिप्रोडक्शन, रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ. व्हाट डज द रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ मीन? द टर्म रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ सिंपली रेफर्स टू हेल्दी रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स विद नॉर्मल फंक्शनिंग. बट अकॉर्डिंग टू वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हु, रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ मीन्स ए टोटल वेलबींग इन फिजिकल, इमोशनल, social and behavioral aspects of reproduction. Thus, reproductive healthy persons have physically and functionally normal reproductive organs and normal behavioral and emotional interactions among them in all sex-related aspects. So, now the question arises, why is it so significant to maintain reproductive health and what are the methods to achieve it? Now, here we'll, in this slide, we'll study some problems and strategies of reproductive health. First of all, what are the problems? Now, first of all, in our country, overpopulation is a problem. Main problem of India is its excess population. And next is early marriage. Children are often married as soon as they attain puberty. Next problem is health of mothers and child. Early marriage leads to several diseases in mothers, and same in the because mother is not able to take care of her child, so diseases occur there also. So next is mother mortality rate and infant mortality rate. Mother mortality rate, again, due to lack of awareness, uneducation, and lack of facilities, mother mortality rate, and then again infant mortality rate occurs. Next one is sexually transmitted diseases. The children who have married earlier, they don't have proper knowledge of reproductive organs, hence the sexually transmitted diseases are common in these persons, just like infectious diseases, which are sexually transmitted diseases. Next is carrier. Early marriage blocks the carrier of the couple, especially of the lady. These are the problems. Next, what are the strategies? Now, strategies are first family planning program. The family planning program, it was invented in 1951. Next is awareness about reproduction. Audiovisual aids, print media, government, non-government agencies are doing good job to create awareness among people about reproduction in women. Parents, close relatives, friends, teachers also can play a major role in giving information. Next one is sex education. So sex education in schools should be introduced and encouraged to provide right information about myths and misconceptions about sex-related aspects. Next is birth control devices and care of mother and child. So here you will study. Birth control devices are just like fertile couples and people of marriageable age group should know about available birth control devices, care of pregnant mothers, postnatal care of the mother and child, importance of breastfeeding, equal importance to male and female child. Next is medical facilities. Medical facilities means better awareness about sex-related problems, parental care of mother, prenatal care of mother, medical-assisted deliveries and postnatal care of mother, and infant decrease maternal and infant mortality. So small families, better detection and cure of sexually transmitted diseases, and increased medical facilities for sex-related problems. So all these are there. Then next is research in reproductive health. It should be encouraged and supposed to find out new methods, just like Saheli is a new oral contraceptive for the females, and it was developed by the Central Derg Research Institute, Lucknow in India. And next one is information about reproduction related problems. So all these are strategies. Government should take care of all these things so that proper family planning program and awareness about sex education and information about all these things should be given to the people. So watching a term, amniocentesis, what does it mean? Amniocentesis is a fetal sex determination and disorder test based on chromosomal pattern in the amniotic fluid surrounded the developing embryo. What is the procedure? So amniotic fluid contains cells from the skin of the fetus and other sources. These cells can be used to determine the sex of the infant, to identify some abnormalities in the number of chromosomes, and to detect certain biochemicals and enzymatic abnormalities if it is established that the child is likely to suffer from a serious incurable congenital defect, the mother should get the fetus aborted. But misuse of amniocentesis is done. It is being used to kill the normal female fetus. It is legally banned for the determination of sex to avoid female feticide. So this is an important term which is generally asked in the examination. Now in this slide, we'll study about population explosion and birth control. So first of all, what does the population mean? Population is defined as the total number of individuals of a species present in a particular area at a given time. A species has many populations living in different regions. And the scientific study of human population is called demography. It deals with many phenomena. We'll learn about them in later. And next one is, what is census? Census is an official counting of population and preparing data about age groups, birth, death, sex ratio, education, etc. In India, first census was carried out in 1872. Now, after every 10 years, it is done. It was last done in 2011 and then 2020-21, now it will be, it's going on. Now, census is conducted as per the provision made under the Census Act 1948. So, India's population as on March 1, 2011, it was given in figures here. You can learn it here. Then males are, number is this, females is number is this. And sex ratio is 940, means 1000 males agar hai to females ka number 940 hai. Kai Rajasthan wagaira mein jahan pe female feticide bahut zyada hai, wahan pe ye number 1000 ke comparison mein 800 700 bhi hai. So government is planning to make it equal. Now we'll study what are the reasons for high population growth, why population explosion is going on. There are two main factors for the increase in human population: decrease in death rate, mainly maternal mortality rate and infant mortality rate is decreased, and increase in the span of life. So these are some features, some reasons are described here. First of all, spread of education. Persons of the country are being educated about the diseases, then control of diseases, control of various communicable diseases is in practice, then advancement in agriculture, farmers are educated to develop high yielding crops, and then storage facilities are there, and then better transport, it protects from famines, and then protection from natural calamity, it decreases death rate, then government is doing much efforts to provide maximum information to the farmers. So all these factors are there because of living standard is increased. So there is death rate is less and high explosion growth is there. So here are consequences of overpopulation. Overpopulation leads to number of not only national but also individuals, family problems also. So some of these are described below. First of all, poverty. If in a family there are more persons and income is less, so naturally it becomes poor. With the addition of every child, the poverty increases. Next one is food supply. If the population increases and the production of food doesn't increase, because we can't increase 1 inch of our land area, so that will lead to the shortage of food supply. Next is hygienic conditions. More people living in small area generally make the hygienic conditions bad, and there will be an accumulation of waste material and it's not removed early. Hygienic utna maintain nahi kar pate. Next one is unemployment. More number of people means more jobs, and if sufficient number of jobs are not available, it leads to unemployment. Next one is pollution. There will be added problems of pollution. Everything is taken from environment in excess, and they will result in pollution. Next one is education problems. It becomes difficult for the government to provide education to all, such like housing problems. For more people, more houses are required, and the houses are not built at high rate. So all these problems are due to overpopulation.